This is the Google form that you people had filled. This is another form that I am making and I will share it later. It is sort of a feedback assessment. Now everyone, I'm logging in as the admin of virtual teaching now. And why I'm saying this thing, because if I would have added you people to employability enhancement on Moodle Cloud, but the issue is different that it doesn't allow more than 50 users. So let me log in into the virtualteaching.genomio.com. There are two quizzes, everyone, if you people remember. These are very, very, they are nothing. So I'm going to add one assignment and one quiz. I'll just demonstrate to you how the quiz was added and how I can add. I have deleted the performance of two participants from this quiz. I think from this one I deleted. And see, yes, I have, no, submitted. Okay. What I'll do is I'm trying to maybe edit the quiz. If I can edit the quiz. Yes, I can. Let me add a, no, I cannot because this has been already, this quiz is open. Okay, you cannot add or remove. There are two attempts. So I click here. If it says that there are two attempts, these are the attempts. Let me select all and delete the selected attempts. The quiz will become again virtual and open for me that I can do the corrections in it. So quiz two, attempts zero. Now it means I can now edit this quiz because attempts have been removed. Let me see if I can edit it. And if it still says there are attempts, it means I did not. Yes, now everyone see I'm adding a question now, adding a new question. And why I'm telling you this thing, it is not multiple choice. Let me add an essay type question. Here is an essay. It allows response to upload a file or type online text. So what I'm doing is I am going to add an essay in the same objective type question, quiz. Question name, essay on the which cultural. Suppose this is what we are talking about. Like I'm talking about our state and then I want people to write of it. Now word limit 500 to 3000 words. Again, you'll recognize it now. General feedback, I'm not adding. Response, HTML editor, not a problem. We can keep it. Plain text, so I'm keeping it HTML editor so they can add on more things. Inbox box size, like input box is where you type. I'm going to make it a bigger one because I'm asking for, like say, so some 25 to 3000 words. Allow attachments, yes, they can add attachment also. How many attachments? As many as they want to. Attachments are optional also, not compulsory. Accepted types, can someone tell me, rather than making the format for the file, see attempted file types, there was a symbol I talked about, which particular symbol I have to put here so that every format can be accepted. Can someone tell me in the chat? Yes, Jasima ji, you were trying to type it right and then you got it right, shift plus 8, the star thing. So I'm putting it here, it means everything. Now, information for graders, who are going to grade it? Check for ORIGIN originality as well, or we can make coherence, we can make grammar. I'm just making it so that I can make it and then see, save changes and continue. This question has got added to the quiz now, and whosoever is going to go to this quiz, the person is going to find this thing there. Now this is the quiz essay on the rich cultural. This is the icon also. This is multiple choice, and this way different types of questions can be added. It is only one mark, so let me make it 20 and then press enter. So that way 30 marks is this. Maximum grade has to be 30, or I can make it, I can make sections of it and then do that to these many questions from these sections. Now everyone, I'm going to participants. No, I'm going to site, you say administration, which is here. Let me see, just because, yeah, it is here. Site administration. Now see, this is the, these are the, I have copied those all email IDs. I've taken all these names as you people had entered. And like, please don't mind, I have made all your names that you had added as your first names, and I have added a last name as CCW. I have made a username as CCW1, and these are your email IDs. And if your email IDs have been typed correct by you, then they are going to remain correct. So I'm going to write here email. Now you can suspect what I'm going to do. What I'm doing is I have made a list of it and made a list, and I'm going to be, now this is meet user. So Kavita ji, I'm going to delete this thing because Kavita ji has by mistake has entered the meeting ID here. Copy paste like was being done, so this might have happened. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete this entry and then see how many users I'm going to meet. 147. Okay, these are the users. Now let me select them just for the sake of, so that I can take a printout of this thing also if needed. I do this, I go to this, and I'm going to save it everyone as a CSV file. This is an Excel sheet I have prepared. Save as the Kaveri TN folder, CCW all users, and then this CSV, and then this. Do you want some features? Okay, I want to keep using it. Let me see if it has been saved. CCW all users everyone. Let me see. This is CCW all users, and let me do this mischief now. I'm going to site admin. There's a possibility that all these users will get emails, or some of them will get emails. Now I'm going to users. Can someone guide me? I've gone to users. After users, what should I do? I am ready with my CSV file. This is my CSV file with CCW all users. What should I do? Upload users. Thank you. I'm going to upload users. What should I do next? Upload user is there. Okay. Next is upload users. The same pop-up message as you have saved the CSV file always appears to Sarina ji, computer science people will tell this thing. Certain things, I being from English literature, I ignored that understanding. It says that change format or this and that. I know that I have to accept what the people are saying because the information gets saved. Upload user. Choose a file. Upload this. Going to our folder. Yes. CCW all users CSV. This is the file, everyone. Upload this file. Now see, because there are more than 150 people, so I am going to make the preview rows as 1000 so that I can just scroll and see all of them. So this is what I want. Everyone, please see this thing and let me know. See, there is one address. This is invalid, akila.k. And if you can see this thing, you can please agree with me. This space is going to stop me. One invalid email address. Then, second invalid reason being there is a space between at the rate and Gmail, if you can see. Then another one, there's a space after this full stop and IT. MSLVPG, and this is not a mistake like which has been done consciously. We just type it that way and does not matter. I'm just trying to tell you that these are the errors. This is a preview that I'm checking. DRBN up Gmail at the rate space is there, and here I have deleted this entry, so this blank has come. Invalid email address, invalid email address because there is a comma. So it says add new only, skip existing. Yes, it should do. Create a password if needed and send via email. And you know, you people are not getting added to any course. You people are going to get added to something which is called what do you say, a site. So in a course I'm not adding you, and I have not created, this is a thing that I have not created a group as well. There is a possibility that I can create a group. A group means a cohort can be added. I'm not creating that thing. I'll create it later as well. Now let me see. Okay. Now, standardized usernames, create password, all this thing is there. Let me upload. And these can be deleted easily as well. You people might get some emails also. Now, these are the people who have got uploaded, and it will tell me if there is any error also. Here, you people have received a password. Last name was missing, so some error is. It says 170 created, 6 errors. I'll say continue. And now these people have been added. I can go to site admin. I can go to, sorry, users. See, in the users, I can go to cohorts for once. Cohort means a group, you say a section that we can say. Add a new cohort. Name is CCW. Context is which one? Moodle training. Cohort ID is, I'll say 2020. Description is CCW all. Save changes. Now this is a cohort I have created, CCW all, and ID is 2020. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going back to the site admin. Cohort thing will explore a bit later. And if some of you have already received some emails, please let me know. Receive the email. Thank you. Now if I go to users, bulk user actions. Now these are the things that I would have appreciated. I would love that if you people explore it in the coming days, and then you can do. See, these are all users, and what filter I want to add? CCW. All the users that contain CCW have been here useful. Then what I'll do, add all. They are what to add to a cohort. This is a thing which is being shared with you one time only, because this falls under the second category of creating things. And for this thing, I would appreciate that if our senior people who have been able to move further with Moodle training, they will be able to guide you more. So I'm adding it to a cohort. All the people who had got that CCW or something, these are the people who are being moved to a cohort. Which cohort? Can you please tell me? I'm going with CCW 2020. It has been added. Now, what I'm going to do, everyone, let me go to the participant. Okay, you received email 123 mail received. Perfect. Now let me invite you people all to the course now as participants. Like, if I see no courses here, that this thing I need to, like, there are 5 users who are enrolling. You are changing your name, you are coming to my Genomio thing, and this thing is going to give me a task that after 5 7 days I have to launch some short course, because I've got 170 students with me. So that I'll do. Now that gives me a responsibility that I'm going to launch a course, and then you people can do that. Now I'm going to add these people as participants. I'm repeating, cohort thing is there. I can do that thing also. Enroll users. I can select the cohort also, because now the cohort has been created. If you see, which one was our cohort? CCW or 2020? CCW. Because we made a cohort called CCW, and then the ID was 2020. Now I'm not doing anything, everyone. See, 170 people. It is going to make it very heavy for me. There are too many users, 100 to show. So I'm not going to do. I simply made a cohort, and see, this is refreshing and changing things. And all these people have been made student, where 173 people are participants in my course. And this is what I'm doing. I'm going to make a quiz, and you people are going to participate in the same quiz. You are there in this course now. So that quiz can be done by you, in which an essay has to be done. You can attach anything to that essay just to see how it works. If I go to grades, all my students will be seen by me. You can change your names also. My concern is your email ID. See, 173 students are the participants, and these are the people, and I can see their grades also. If the people are going to do, let me show you another thing, whether how many of them have logged in. I can see if I have sent things to them, last access to the course. Let's sort it by clicking on this last access. I'm going to bring those on the top who have accessed and those who have not joined or logged in. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, these people have joined, these people have logged in, and other people must be logging in. So it gets activated. I'll get this thing very soon. So what I'll do, select all 773 users. Let me select all 173 users have been selected. I'm sending a mass message to everyone, but it will appear as an individual message. All selected. At the bottom, what I have is, even like if I don't, I'm going to send them a common message. So what I'm going to do, I have selected all. You see that 20 per page, but I chose to select send a message. Welcome to Learning with Me. This is the plugin in Google Chrome called Grammarly. 173 people coming to you. And everybody can be added later on also. Don't worry about it. It is a test that I'm doing. I have just shared with you the cohort creation. I'll move on to H5P now. I have mentioned quiz and everything. So those people who have received the message, they people can let me know. See, all these are the messages which have been sent. So, mail received. If you have received a message also, you can let me know. Got the email. Okay. Audio is not clear, Anita ji. Please check it out again. I'm trying to improve the audio as well. Mail received. Message received. Yes, very good. Ramya ji, message received. Now done. This thing we have tested. What we have done is, we have uploaded everyone there, and then we went to users. You say bulk user actions in the site admin, and after that we simply applied a filter. The filter was CCW, because the username had CCW as well. So the moment CCW is there, a filter is applied, everything comes on the screen, select all, and then add them to a cohort. Before that thing, you have to go to site admin, go to users, go to add a cohort and create a cohort. Cohort is the section. Section A, section B, section C, as we do batches, we can say. Thank you very much, everyone. Message has been received. I've been able to show you the functioning. Let's go to another wonderful thing and the last thing for the day, which is called H5P. Before that, how to take a backup. And see, you will say that, Mr. Praveen, that was not the toughest thing to do. I'll show you how to take a backup. Let me show you how to take a backup of public speaking, because I have added a few things there. In the public speaking course, if I go, I'll show you how to take a backup. Message received. Are you people ready to learn how to take a backup? Please let me know. Okay. Done. Now I'm curious about it. There is one thing. Like, if I am going to ask you as a younger participant, I am getting this thing now. Yes or yes. Like, do they have something like in Tamil? You people say this word. Like, there is this is a short word for something that we people speak there. And because most of us are typing yes, and then it means that there is something like it's superb, sir, or it is point taken, sir, or something. I'm just curious about it. Now let's move on to the course. This is the public speaking course, everyone. This is the video which is there, and it has been made through Powtoon. Powtoon is an online site where we make animated videos. This video is available on the website also, and I have shared with you the website URL yesterday, and I'll share it today as well. And I am not requesting you that way, but I wish that most of you join it. And the reason is not that I'll ask for subscribers. The reason is that it will because sometimes we forget to send WhatsApp to people or Facebook messages or LinkedIn or tweets. So we need to have multiple connectivity ways that we can reach them. Chaliye, let's move on to the course, Public Speaking Everyone. This is Public Speaking Everyone. Now, to which side I should go, right or left for turn editing on? Turn editing on, where should I go? This is, I have opened the course, please see, Communication Skills category under PS is Public Speaking. I should go right side. Can someone see the word called backup? Can you see the word backup? You can see it. I clicked. Can you see there are different, there's a sequence of things. The sequence is number one, initial settings, schema settings, confirmation and review, perform the backup and complete. So it has selected that these are the things it will get into the backup. It will get all your blocks, activities and resources. If you can see user role assignment, student and something. Why? Because everything include grade history if you want, course logs if you want. Suppose you have made a course at 3.5. Sometimes it is tough to make a course at 3.5 and upload it on 3.8 because the version is different. Like you design something in Microsoft Word 2003 and then you want it to open on 2017 or 19 or 16. So sometimes it does say so. So what we are doing is we are selecting these options that I want these things under the backup. And you can go schema settings, confirmation review, perform backup and complete. Okay, let me go one by one. It says I'm taking backup of these things. It says I'm just telling you that these are the things I have taken in the backup. I'm yet to like take the backup though. These are the, okay, we are getting smart tips and methods to best speech practice. Every module is being copied. I say no, there is nothing added in the smart tips and methods to prepare. I don't use the data. I don't want the data. Neither I want the user performances, nor I want the notes, because there is nothing there. But then I thought, no, I can have this, but I don't want user data, because new users will be using this thing in the on the new site. At present, I'm keeping it as it is. Next. This is final backup. This is the name of the backup. I can say CCW test backup. I am naming it. And see how I have come here is wherever at turn editing on was there, at the same place the backup word was there. And I am performing the backup. The backup is performed. The backup file was successfully created. I'll say continue. Now the backup file is there. Where it is, PS, it is giving me the option to restore. Here is the backup file, everyone. CCW test backup. Let me download this. Desktop C MBZ. The format is MBZ 5.9. The moment you click on the course, rather than turning editing on, you simply scroll a bit down and then you see backup and you click on backup and then you do all those things and simply you can perform a backup. So that is the thing that you do. So this is what I had about taking a backup, how to restore a backup, whether it has to be downloaded or can it be there in Moodle. It remains in Moodle site as well, ma'am. It is saved in the Moodle site itself, because the moment you will click on the word restore, it will show you the previously created backups. Now there is a thing called Akiba backup. My friends from computer science and IT, again I'm referring to you to acknowledge this thing. Our websites, the servers, they have got those plugins and those applications in them that take automatic backup of the data. If it is true, then you can please type and then let everyone know that it is true. So that automatic backup, after every 7 days, 5 days, you can do it. And in the future also, you can install that backup. Now that backup has got installed. Let me see this. And let me see, yes, it is. And let me open our course. And I'm just trying, I'm not sure where, yeah, this is an MBZ file. So this 5 MB sent to you in the WhatsApp group, you try downloading it completely. And then if you can do the thing that I'm going to do, that would be perfectly fine. I'm giving you a couple of minutes to download that WhatsApp file. If it works, I click here. I'm not turning the editing on. I'm just moving on to backup. Let me go to restore. See what I have. I have nothing. Why? Because this course hasn't been backed up yet. But if I go to public speaking, that course has been backed up. So import a backup file. Let me bring that backup file here and let it install on the Moodle training and CCWVT. The backup is of public speaking. MBZ file is there, everyone. This is CCW test MB. Now this is ES backup. I'm just typing it, though it won't ask for a compulsion. But just after you upload your backup, it will ask you to which category you want to install it, what name you want to give it as a new name. So these things are also possible. If you just miss it and just keep on moving from one step to another step, please remember it will come as a duplicate. Choose the file chosen, restore. I'll say, yeah, go ahead. When it is going to restore what I have taken, now can you see this thing, everyone? Type is course Moodle 2 general 3.512. This is what it is. 3.512 is there. So this is what like it is. This is the backup I have created and I have taken. I'm uploading it. Now see, all these things are coming in the backup. I'm restoring the backup. I'll say continue. Now everyone, to which category you people want me to put it? In the Moodle training, I guess only then I'll be able to prove. See, this is subcategory employability skill, this is communication skills, and this is Moodle training. I'm throwing it to Moodle training. I can add one thing into a particular course itself. Like you can add one course into another course, everything will get merged. So these are the things which are there. I'll say bring all these things to this course. Now, public speaking is the course name. Let me take it. This is the backup test. Short name is backup BPS, backup of public speaking. Now, course start date. You have taken a backup. You can give it a course start date also. We can, because the earlier date was 11. So let me make it now 13. Which is tomorrow, not today. These are the things which are coming. You can make it final that you need user data or not. Then the user data will be there. I say, no, I want it to be a fresh course so I can say deselect this thing. But at present, I'm keeping it selected just to show you how a backup comes.
Yeah.
Now, final step, everyone. Final step is perform the restore. Like now, you see the course was restored successfully. Click continue. Now, what is the number of total courses on virtualteachingjnomio.com after adding this course? Can somebody type? What is the total number of courses you expect is there? And see, suppose I go here. Or you people can do one thing. Let me throw it to you all. You people are members of the site, but you people are members of one course only. So you can see on the site there are courses, but you cannot enter into this backup thing. So you can verify it yourself because you're already logged in into the same course. Like if I go to site home and see what are the courses which have been like taken by me. Now on the site home, I have got backup test. See, this is the same available courses. This is the site image, available courses 1, 2, and everyone 3. So you can see the same thing and it is here also. So I have installed the backup. If you people have downloaded the file I had sent to you, you can also try restoring it. And how you restore it, you go to site admin. Like you go to site admin, you go to course, and you can simply, then I guess it is simple, site admin, course, restore a course. You click on restore a course. Now we are at the parent, you say. Restore a course means you can restore a course from here. Whatever you have designed and you have managed to take the backup of it, you can upload it. You can take a backup of one quiz only. You can take a backup of one unit only. All these things are possible. Suppose one unit is same with me and you. So what we'll do is you will prepare every material for it and I will take the backup from you and will install on my site. I have taken a backup of a particular complete course, not a site, complete course. So let me show you how we can take a backup of a particular unit, or you people can simply click on that thing where you used to type edit. Turn editing on is for editing course, but I'm talking about taking backup of a particular topic. There also the word backup and restore is there. Like if I turn the editing on, rather than taking this backup and restore for the whole course, let me go to turn editing on and check it out. Can I take backup of the quiz? Edit? No. Then I can take backup of an activity, though it is possible somewhere. It is, this feature is there. I might be missing it. Where is the backup? Yeah, here it is. You enter into a module and then you do it here, and then you can take a backup. So I'm taking the backup of a quiz. Include enrolled users. Now what I'm doing, I'm taking the quiz backup. So this is the path, quiz, and then I'm taking the backup. And this is how you do it. So I'm canceling the backup for now and moving on to the H5P interactive content. Will show you just one thing, just for the sake of time. Let me open the site. This is the user. Let me go to my site now. Can you please post your say observations about the things like we have discussed now? The restore and the backup thing, like backup and restore, that's the process. Have you people found it understandable? Please post it so that I don't feel that burden that I was running in some speed, though I have tried to be as slow as I could. We are learning how to add interactive contents. Can someone type in the chat a few words about our college? Can you just type 15 words, anybody from my namesake subject, English and Communication Skills? Type something, that college name and this history and something. Just type two sentences about anything. Two sentences together. Sort of 15 words together, a sentence. I'll show you how the fill in the blanks is possible. So when you people are typing those 15 words, I'm moving on to add activity and resource. Attendance we had checked. Let me go to interactive content, H5P. H5P modules, please see this. This is there. So I'm clicking here. And I'm again repeating, you add a module first, you give it a title, and then the module is added, then you enter into the module after returning to the course. You here only we are not like going to find something. So description is fill in the blanks. Now everyone see, because I have activated it already, otherwise you would see, what would you see? You would see a button like this, get. I request someone, most of you, if you can try, please do it right now. Go to any topic, add activity and resource, go to interactive content H5P, and you will give it a name, and then you will see there is a button called get. So I want you people to click on almost everything once and then get all of them, because I did it last night that when I was installing it, you have to get these things, audio recorder and all these things. But what we are using is, we are just using fill in the blanks. So I'm clicking here, fill in the blanks, and this activity is getting added here. Okay, I have taken it, Jashri ji. Got it from you. There's so many people who have done. Okay, I'm just taking the third one because that came just in front. Now see everyone. About CCW. This is the title, used for searching reports and copyright information that way. Task description, fill in the blanks, and instructions have been given. And you can see all, what is the instruction? Instruction is anything which comes between the star becomes a blank, and students are going to fill that thing. Now, this is what you have sent me. What I'm going to do, I am going to put a star and you will see what it becomes, because all of you are a student of, I guess, this course only. Can you please let me know to which course I had enrolled you? Can you please type, if you have got an email, to which course you people got enrolled? To which course you got enrolled? Okay, you went to CCWT. Fine. Now, if you people are students in it, the moment I'm going to add it, I want you people to check whether this thing has appeared for you or not. Now, I'm imposing this thing on you. Because you know the answer, everyone. Please don't worry. This is not cheating. I'm making the question paper in front of you. I'm just doing one thing. Let me go to grade, no grade, display the action bar. Okay, copyright button, no copyright button, enjoy it as CC, save and return to the course. Now, can I request you people to check it out? Topic number two, about CCW, fill in the blanks. Can you just hunt for it if you people have enrolled in the course and you are a student? I can see I've got 170 participants. Can you people check it? What, how does it show to you? Virtual teaching. Okay, got it. Can you people check how this fill in the blanks activity has come to you? And it is quite easy. Like there's nothing much. If H5P has been activated as a plugin by you, then this thing is there. It is inbuilt, it is within the site, but you just need to click on get for all those things that you people are going to use. Yeah, Haseena ji, Divyaji, I've got it. I have posted in WhatsApp. Okay, you posted something in WhatsApp. Oh, great, doctor, thank you. You have relieved me from a burden. Now, so what you people can do is, can you people click on this reuse, R-E-U-S-C? Can you click on reuse and download this file, and you can upload it in yours also, but don't do it. We don't fight for it, because we already have access to this thing. So this is quite easy. Dr. S. Abhinya, now you have logged in. You can fill in the blanks. The drag and drop is also there, everyone. I didn't use that. I can show you that thing now. This is fill in the blanks. We could do drag and drop also. Yeah, this is good. Very nice. Now this is a practice one, and yeah, we have done it pretty well. So if I go to this, this is one activity that I've added. I could have added another one. Let me go to CCW fill in the blanks. Let me try things here only. Now see, this is here. If I can add more things. H5P, everyone remember h5p.org. Do not go to the site which says 30 days trial. This is what like is going to make it tough for you. Don't go for the 30 days hosting free and something. Go for H5P, which is free of cost. I'm posting it. It is h5p.org. Actual link is this one. I'm installing fill in the blanks. Yeah, you install every like you the one you want. Now see, this is one thing that we people have done. Add a text block, or see, I can add a range also. Like earlier, those of you people have attempted. Now let me add a range: 0% to 30%. Do try again. 31 to 50. Good. But try 51 to 100, 51 to 80, better. And this is well done. Oh, welcome. No. Now this is what you people have done. I have added a range. Behavioral settings can also be there. Enable retry. I'll say no retry. Enable show solution. Okay, solution can be seen by you. I'll say no. Automatically check answers after input. This, all these things, case sensitive, no, they can, because see, there is a women thing. In the name of the college, W has to be capital. When you are writing it for women, then W can be small. So I'm making it case sensitive, and these things are there. Now, display option, display action bar, okay, all these things are there. Now, let me add one more text block. Now, one more text block is possible. So another text, another thing can be added. One activity has been added from my side here. And this is what I have done. And where the drag and drop thing is. Yeah, here it is, drag and drop. Change content type. Then the content type will be changed. Again, one module, one activity, one thing will be there. So what I'm going to use is now, let me, title is drag the words to write twice. Background image, okay, let me give you a background image also. Background image, let's take the college itself. I'm again going to the checkbox and finding out the description, the text that you people have given me. Now I can take it from Nilofer G. Here it is, this is the image. Okay, task size, add a range. See, what we have done is this one is a different one, that we can drag the things and drop them onto the image. Now, so this is something like, these are different things which are there. You can like, you can insert images, you can make them drag images and create the map of something like step 2, step 3. All these things are there. You can use their tutorials also. Such activities are there. Like if I click here, drag and drop, I can select another activity, accordion, arithmetic. There was one thing that I wanted to show you. Dialogue cards are there, images. Yeah, here it is, drag the words. I wanted to show this thing actually. The image one can be done, but for that thing, I have to keep some images ready. Now see what is there. Now in this one, this is drag and drop, and I'm going to type it here. I am taking your session on Moodle, but the mode of communication here is Google Meet. I am not just teacher today, but a student as well. Now I am putting those stars, but activity I have selected is drag the words. And what you will get as an exercise now is, let me see, okay, a message. I'm not doing anything, I'm not giving you the grading thing and all those things. Those who perform well, they get those messages, as you have seen my message. Please someone try it. There is a my message type of thing, or even this is visible to me also, I can also do thing. Okay, I'm done with it, so I can check it. I have scored 4 out of 4, Embed with a star. Let me see what you have got. You can drop me images, please. Let me see WhatsApp. Yeah, pretty fine. You can simply, if you are using a mobile phone, just keep your finger on it and then drag it to the place where you can. I had shared with you, you say, an application called AZ recorder. You can use it cautiously. There's nothing in danger that way, but like you do explore it. Suppose you people are making some tutorials through the mobile phone, then you can use it. Okay, messages come. Yeah, very good. There are people in competition with me then. Thank you, Anirudh. Okay, Anirudh, thank you. Now this is how, this is the name which appears with the phone number, so this is what I know about you. Check your Gmail login ID. Yeah, Rita ji, wrong window. Wanted to send it to someone else. Yeah, good, good, good. There are people who are attempting it. See, you are students now. Now, this is there. And let me do one thing. If I suppose like you people are, if you people are finding it well, H5P. My question is there in the chat. I need your feedback. Thangam, ma'am, we are in the same team. Let's talk about the participants. Yeah, we are, because we didn't do this H5P during the CIT thing. I think so. You can remind me if we had done this. Oh, great. H5P. Yeah, we did it. Okay, I didn't do that with the batch I guess I was taking. I'm not sure. Attendance we had done. Now, very nice. Let me look at the agenda now. The agenda for today or both days. You can keep on giving your feedback, everyone. I'm just going to the agenda just to verify. I have touched everything. I have discussed everything and justified the time that you have given me for these 2 days, and I assured that we'll be ending up around 5. So I am just going to like conclude in a few minutes. So the agenda was, okay, Moodle site changing password done, customizing the dashboard was discussed and done, the recording is available on YouTube, creating course category, creating course, then adding the topics, announcement, news forums and chats, label also, page URL file, activity, assignments. I have mentioned book to you. So book was done by Dr. Abhirami and then Mrs. Thangam also. They people can also like share with you that thing. I have shared about OERs. Then users and participants, we have done in a very good manner that way, adding all of you to a site and making you a student. Then we have done how to message them, how to remove them from the courses at the same place. Like the same place where I have shown you, as you have seen also, it is there in the recording as well. The same place where I selected send message to the selected users, the option was remove their enrollment. Now we have done subjective questions I added, assignments I added. Grading means that when you have received an assignment, so you grade it and that is easy. H5P we just did, question bank, individual question we tried and we did, adding users in bulk and individually we did, how to take up backup we did, demonstrations of Moodle site course developed by participants, you have got those 2 days with you when you will be doing it, sharing the work and queries. So here it is, looking at the chat. Okay. Nice. You people can share your queries now if you people want to. I'm stopping my screen. If you people have got any query, it is for you. I'm giving the baton to the team now, who have been organizing it pretty well. So you people can share your feedback if you want to, or you people can share your observations. You people can scold me if I have been rude or I have been a bit quick and fast. Over to you.
Staff members, now the session is open for feedback as well as any query or discussion forum. So first of all, I would like to register my feedback. Thank you so much. I know you are very busy rendering virtual training to many institutes. Thank you for accepting our invitation too. And thank you for being so involved. We saw your messages being popped by 12:20 when even it was in time. You used to post many messages as well as information. Thank you so much. And we would like to be in touch with you always. Even we have a plan to invite you for a review meeting also, once the Moodle has been installed in our domain or server. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. You have been a great support, every one of you. And if there is a faculty like who has got something to say, they can say, thank you so much, is same to you. Like this is,
and yeah, don't, sure.
Yeah. And what one thing I want to tell everyone is, see, at the end of the day, I'm a teacher. So don't worry about it. The thank you is not going to please me. If you're not going to end up making your sites and making use of it, you know how you deal with your students. So don't worry. I'm a teacher, and I'm glad to be among all of you. And see, I couldn't travel to Tamil Nadu and those places. Like one of my students, whose name I have used, Sultan Rashid, he's from Rameshwaram. And he's like a younger brother to me. So like, I always wanted to go to his home, but he shifted to Australia now. But through you people, I've been able to travel virtually. Now I've got people who know me in that part of India also.
Yeah, we were really amazed when we look into your profile, also being a professor of English, and you're technically sound.
And sir, we are always happy to welcome you. Thank you so
I'll
much,
come.
Sir.
I'll come to the college.
Yeah.
The moment.
Sure, most. Yes, and as you said, as a teacher, thank you will not please you. We know how to please a teacher. So probably we will have a session with you, maybe after some 3 or 4 months, and we will show how we have progressed. So there at that time, you,
for sure,
you rank us. That would,
yes,
really make you happy.
See, I can conclude with this thing. There's nothing about ranking. You say, the best teachers make the best students, and when you're talking to the students, I generally tell them that you're going to be the best student. They say, how? I'll say, I'm the best teacher that way. So don't worry.
Sure.
You people,
sure.
There's no ranking. You people are already doing pretty well. You people will do well.
Yeah, so, thank you, sir.
Thank you. So if there is no query, and you people are like, take rest, do some kind of yoga that you people know, or breathe in and out only.
Yeah, may I now request our head of the Department of English, Dr. Jayashree Agarwal, to render the vote of thanks, please.
Thank you, Abhirami ma'am. Good evening. I'm immensely honored and find gratification to elaborately express my gratitude on this notable occasion of our institution, a virtual FDP, a two-day online faculty development program on virtual teaching tools, being in the midst of this gathering of remarkable, enthusiastic learners. Foremost, I express my thankfulness and individually and collectively to our virtual guru and resource person, Mr. Praveen Kumar Sharma, who has been continuously present with us on the Google Meet, WhatsApp, emails, and all the various forms of electronic media, pre and post session, and for having used his almost 13 years of online teaching and learning experience, and for having served us so willingly. Thank you, sir. It shows us that you so truly believe in collaboration and constructive teaching and learning. And navigation has been of immense value, and greatly appreciate your inputs, valuable time, punctuality, and all your efforts to help us comprehend the various digital possibilities to learn, relearn, and unlearn. I'm specifically thankful to Madam Principal Dr. V. Sujata, who always urges us to be innovative and unique. Her energy and enthusiasm is manifested in all our activities, and we keep notching up our potentials higher because of her drive and perennial involvement. Thank you, Madam. I take this opportunity to thank the philanthropic members of the Reddy management who strive constantly to raise the standards of our institution, Kaveri College for Women Autonomous, and it's purely their magnanimity which encourages us to endeavor beyond our barriers. I will be failing in my duty if the organizing team is not congratulated for the mammoth planning, coordination, provision of technical support through the IQAC coordinator and controller of examination, Ms. Ramya, and she wishes me to thank you, Praveen Kumarji, for your excellent presentation, and she wants me to convey that it's wholehearted and it's not just formal, and I'm sure it truly is. And Dr. H. Abhirami, Dean of Science, for a constant coordination and implementation. I also thank the Vice Principals, Dr. S. Ramalakshmi, Dr. Sindhu Janita Prakash, Dean of Arts, Dr. Savitri, Dean of Alumni, Dr. Kanaga, the various adjunct departments, faculty members, especially from CSIT Computer Application, for their virtual support and participation. Network problem, lack of resources, power failure, everything has gone for the toss. The participants have proved that when there is a will, there is a way. Thanking each and every one of you for rising above challenges and making the session a fruitful one. Praveen Kumar sir, we assure you that this lockdown will be remembered for transforming some of the digital immigrants as digital natives. Thank you for bearing up with the bad voice. It's the wrong occasion to have such a bad voice and heavy throat. But this is Professor Jayashree Agarwal, Assistant Professor and Head Department of English UG. And this one last line, sir, medium virtual hai, lekin hamara abhar dil se hai, kindly accept our many dil se dhanyavad, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. Like, I'll say thank you. You people have been excellent. You people have been very nice. So we'll wind up now, and thank you to the families. Thank you to the children around you. Thank you to the husband. Thank you to the elder people at home, those who facilitated for you people who are managing 2-3 worlds together, not just a college or a home, or the self or the family. Thank you very much. Do convey my thanks to the children around you and the parents who are there and the family. Thank you very much. So if you allow me to sign out, I will.
Yes.
Sure, ma'am. So
thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay, ma'am. Signing out. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye. Bye, sir.